Whoever sees this and subscribes right now, get a free smile. It takes a lot less muscles than it does to frown. What's going on, YouTube? It's one only Noxo, and we're back with our reaction series. So today, man, listen, we have just finished our Ren interview. Hopefully you guys have seen it. It's a hell of a conversation. I'll put the links to it below if you want to check it out. But I thought, you know what? Let's keep this Ren train going. There's an artist that we talked about that he recommended to me that I want to dive into. So it's none other than Ren and Chinchilla. And this right here is Chalk Outlines. 1981, 82, 78. Where is it? That's pretty cool. If you notice how we open, right? You've got the folio of the moment, which we've talked about before, just that sound captured within that microphone. But then there's some other production that happens off to the side. And here there was like this weird kind of noise, almost like a ghost in the mix, like this white noisy type of stuff that was like building and creating this tension. And that actually led to the lights flickering and then the sound of those lights. But then after the lights flickered, that like buildup all of a sudden went away. And then it just transitioned fully over to like the sound folio of the moment. Just pretty cool little stuff in the production of this to build some suspense. And at first I thought we're in like a old ass library, but now this looks even better. I mean, this is exactly where I'm gonna get murdered tomorrow. Wow. Again, post-production, like that snap echoed, and you heard it echo in the hallway, but then it echoed even further in the mix, and there was like some reverb on it. So that's pretty cool. They took the actual sound from that moment and then sent it through audio engineering and then mixed that out as well just to enhance it further.
I hope that I'm someone else in the morning. So take this one, wash it down, and you'll be fine. And walk around in the floating chalk outline.
Wow. That's a hell of a line. Walk around floating in a chalk outline. Because normally chalk outlines are around bodies on crime scenes, right? So what's being implied there to me is walking around a chalk outline, you're walking around like a zombie, basically, like you're the walking dead almost. You might be dead inside. And the way that he describes it, crawling into bed, you picture a Ren going through, you know, his sickness, maybe even going through treatment because they tell him, wash it down, you'll be fine. But we know he was misdiagnosed. Right. So he was given the wrong pills. He was given the wrong meds. But they're like, hey, this will solve it. There's a little bit of a sinisterness underneath of that line. Wash it down. You'll be fine. Drugs can fix everything, all of your situations and problems. And then I think there was another sentiment, too. Hang on.
This one, wash it down. Else in the morning.
That's it. You'll be someone else in the morning. And you could take that in two ways. You could take that as he's hoping to go through recovery and to improve himself so he feels like a new person, a new him. Or it could be that he's suffering so much that he's just wishing and hoping that he could be in someone else's shoes to just end the suffering.
Wash it down and you'll be fine.
Love that. And right there, the fine, you hear it. I talked about the post-production mixing of this. Like, as he sings that just kind of reverbs out and just, like, balances off into the soundscape of space.
Walk around in the floating chalk outline. ballast on my toes so I can breathe.
Wow.
But little by little, bit by bit, I push it back down with a new habit.
Oh.
If not for long, just for a while, I'll bury myself with a great big smile. Oh my, my, oh my, my.
Wow.
We trace ourselves in these chalk outlines. Oh my, my.
We trace ourselves in these chalk outlines. I take that as, you know, we're the ones creating our own graves for ourselves in this state of being. And there's definitely symbolism to the drugs and to taking these meds, and then to this fogginess that it creates in our mind, and just how that feels and how we try to balance ourselves. And then there were some important lines too about falling into a new habit to like cope with this. So I can't cope with the medication, so now I'm turning to like more recreational drugs and other drugs just to try to balance myself out. And then even before that, lines building into that, just smooth melody. And just, man, this is like a combination of very serious lyricism, but also it's melodic, it's smooth, man. This is a hit at the same time, and I love Ren's voice. I've been doing so much of his raps, you forget how good his voice is singing-wise.
I push it back down with a new habit.
Yeah, that's an important line, but hang on, it's before this.
Balanced on my toes so I can breathe.
That's it.
Let it be. Gallows.
Yeah. I really love that just picture painting right there. When you're in the gallows, right, you're going to the hangman's noose, the gallows to be hung. But in the gallows, basically, you have a rope around your neck and he's pushing up on his toes because he doesn't want to be choked out. He's struggling for breath. So at the same time, there's like this hopelessness, this despair, feeling like he's trapped, like he's being choked, but also like he's still fighting, like he's still pushing for hope. And he's just barely on like a razor's edge between kind of just like life and death and just like falling into it all, into that space. Man, love the poetry.
I push it back down with a new habit. If not for long, just for a while, I'll bury myself with a great big smile.
Great line.
Oh my, my, oh my, my, we trace our chalk outlines. Oh my, my, oh my, my. Erase ourselves in these chalk outlines.
Oh, hello.
Sip of serotonin.
Sertraline and a sip of serotonin? I mean, hello, a new player has entered the arena. The lights flash, and all of a sudden, the camera finally reveals what I thought was empty space before. She's like a ninja appearing. But sertraline, that's an antidepressant, right? And serotonin, obviously, you know, helps to balance our emotional chemistry and what's going on. So a lack of serotonin can lead to anxiety and depression. Again, just reflecting these sentiments. Was that an empty beer can? Beer bottle right there? No? No, that's the radiator. What am I thinking?
Sertraline and a sip of serotonin. Don't cry, cause there's a pill for everything.
Wow. Look at those nails. She's like a wolverine. A she-wolverine with the voice of an angel.
Sit down and you'll be fine.
Echoing Ren's sentiments.
The feeling goes when you draw a choke out on.
Wow.
So it goes, let it be. In the gallows, I'm balanced on my toes so I can breathe.
Nice duet of them coming together, especially with Chinchilla in this higher range. I love her voice and just the tone to her voice. And just there's always something about duets with a male and a female voice and just coming together. And then her lyrics, you know, there's a pill for everything. And that is kind of the sentiment of today in the way that the drug industry is set up. You know, if you have back pain, here's pills for this. And we all know how the OxyContin epidemic was born and everything that was dealt with that. But it just seems like for every single issue that you have nowadays, it's okay, here's some pills. You know, sure, pills can help, but there's other forms of therapy and roads to recovery that are needed, and, you know, root issues and things that need to be addressed. It needs to be a more holistic approach. So I can't help but think that there's definitely this commentary on, you know, two people struggling and just being force-fed pills to cope with their anxiety, their stresses, their depressions, whatever they're dealing with. And it's just, it's not enough. And then ironically, they turn to more drugs, and then they're making their own chalk outlines as they walk around feeling just not whole and in this haze inside.
In the girl, I'm balanced on my toes so I can breathe. But little by little, bit by bit, I'm pushing back down with a new habit.
Nice.
It's not for long, just for a while. I bury myself with a great big smile.
Climb. And listen, I forgot the memo to wear white today. I know I did that in the interview with Ren, but I'm going on the opposite side of the spectrum today. Love the syncing up though, not only with the outfits but with these harmonies together. Man, what a chemistry.
It's such a perfect day, take it just in case, take it just in case.
Wow.
I'm scared of being okay, 'cause all things change.
It's such a perfect day, take it just in case. And that's so human in dealing with anxiety, right? The day could be great out there, but, you know, just in case things might go wrong, might as well pop this pill. And that's the danger to recovering from something, for trying to get over an addiction, is, you know, you become so reliant on it because change can be scary. There's so many unknown variables and conditions with change, and it's just safer to take, you know, the road that we have traveled more so, the ones that we know, you know, the enemy that we know versus the great unknown out there. You know, we all say that we can adapt to change and change is good for us, but when it comes down to it psychologically, we all struggle to an extent with a change in our environment because it's that fear of the unknown and then that safety and that comfort with the habits that we have formed.
'Cause all things change, all things change. It's such a perfect day, it's a beautiful shame.
Wow.
It's a beautiful shame.
Wow, she's really going up.
I'm scared of being okay, 'cause all things change. But little by little, bit by bit, I'll push it back down with a new habit. If not for long, just for a while, I'll bury myself with a great big smile. Oh, mama, oh, mama, we trace ourselves in these chalk outlines. Oh, mama, oh, mama, erase ourselves in these chalk outlines.
Oh, wow. And the lights take us out. I love that last bit too, when everything just cut out and you heard their dynamic together. And then Ren came back in on the guitar and kind of raised it, right? So it was like a rushing wave where things drop and you bring it, the audience in. And then all of a sudden he pushes it and then they push with the guitar. And then the guitar kicks out one last time. And then you end on Chinchilla. And you just let that last note and that last tone kind of like hold us in suspense and carry us out. And you can even hear it in the mix as it just like, again, reverberates out and just carries off into space. And what a haunting song and sentiment. And again, another amazing one take video. Another amazing live performance right there in the moment. And it's just, beautiful melody and so relatable, but so poetic and symbolic at the same time. Man, the power of music. Ren, Chinchilla, you were Noxo certified. Hope you guys like today's video. Listen, if you're here at the end, obviously enjoy the content. Do me a huge favor, support the channel directly. Subscribe, notifications on. It really, really does go a long way. I love you. Stay safe, stay positive. It's one only Noxo. You know, I'll catch you again.
Hello. Hi. On the internet. Welcome everyone and every bar. Are you sad or mad or horny? Here's advice, here's some thoughts. Are you out? Well, come be social.